Hi there, I'm back. Video Salt Stack in action. And today I want to give a demonstration how you can create firewall rules. And first a little scenario. So we have like the firewallware outside. We have a bunch of servers here. And those are all in the same VLAN. And let's say it's like 200 servers. It's /24 network. And here's the internet, and people try to break in, of course, into your systems, but it's nicely insecure. So that's fine. So this is your firewall, your hardware-based firewall, right? That's managed by the company, so that's secure. But you also have some servers in this network, perhaps that can reach out to the internet, right? That go to some website, and that website is always trusted. They go to some address, www.123.com, doesn't matter. And all of a sudden, this vendor was always trusted, but all of a sudden they got compromised. They're running an old Apache, for instance, I don't know, Apache old one, and they got compromised. Yeah, right? So this server now inside of your network is reaching out to that server of that external party to get some content from time to time. But it doesn't, is not aware that this is compromised now. So it's serving different content than you would expect. And so it's this server got something back because they found out that it's not fully patched. And they found some vulnerability. And now this system is on red, so to speak, right? And here comes the local firewall into the picture because your central firewall here, you can forget about that whole thing. Big cross that does nothing, that cannot protect you from the side channeling that can occur here. So this guy now is at least able to reach out in the same network to like 199 other servers and can potentially find other weaknesses inside of other servers. And from there they can compromise another box. And this box perhaps has network access to another VLAN, right? And in that VLAN live not a lot of other servers. And then they find another target there, for instance. That system is not patched. And from there they go to another. You can imagine that. And at some point they will reach your storage network, your domain controllers, your PKI infrastructure, perhaps, for your certificates. And you really need to take care of that. And you can do that with the Windows firewall, for instance, or Linux, of course. But this example is Windows, and you can secure them from each other. So I want to be secured from my neighbors as well, The central firewall is nice. It protects me from other VLANs and from the outside world, but it does not protect me from the same network I'm sitting in, right? You're sitting in this /24 network, so everybody in that network can see each other without any filtering. And the Windows firewall, between those systems can protect you also cross, from there to there. So yeah, it's a bit of a messy drawing, excuse me, but I think you got the picture there that it's really like a vulnerability here. And we're going to solve this by implementing firewall rules with SaltStack on all those Windows servers so they can be protected from side channeling. And how we do that? Pretty easy, of course. It's salt, so it's pretty declarative. What I did, and I don't know if I still have it open here. I think let me search for that. The firewall module, firewall. Let me see. Windows firewall state. Windows firewall. Let's see if we get some more back there. Spinning up the minions. Hang on, let me get that link. Yeah, let me see. I found it. Yes. This is the module we're going to use to implement those firewall. And I think I got the wrong one, by the way. Hang on one second. I think it's the. Is this one? Yes. So we have like the add rule here, right? We want to add new rules. And what can we stick in? A name. We can stick in a local port, the protocol. You see here what's allowed. The action, if it's allowed or blocked, you can even block stuff. That will be nice in perhaps in your scenario, with the side channeling stuff. You can do bypass. That's not smart, of course. You have a dir. That's the direction. So is it inbound or outbound traffic? And what do I mean by that? If you're, for instance, sitting on this box here, this box, and you're getting some traffic from this server is reaching out to you, then for you that's inbound traffic, and for this guy it's outbound. And of course, if you reach out from there, let's take another color, from this guy to that guy, then for this guy it's in, and for that guy it's out. Okay? And you configure that here with the out and the in. And you give it a nice name, that name will be present inside of the Windows Firewall UI if we open that later. So here you can specify some networks, for instance this, you can even do this. For instance, you specify one IP address, you can only come from that IP address. No other is allowed, so that's really shielding yourself, from that side channeling stuff. And yeah, here you can do some fine-grained stuff, and you can also specify whole networks, like here /16. That's a lot of IP addresses. Here's more tightly controlled, /24. You can imagine the power right here, and this very large network /8. Right. So here we basically setting up some rules, and in a declarative state, you see, just specifying what we want to do, not how, and now we go back to the shell here, and let me see. Yeah, let's apply this. Let's see what happens. So you see, everything is green. Just RDP to that box to see if we have some firewall rules there, actually. Should have something there. Should be able to go to the firewall here, and then you have like inbound rules, you see, and outbound rules. Those are exactly what you see here, you see, those were created, and those exactly conform our example here. And I'm just going to be sure to save this and commit it, because I'm not sure if I did that. And then I go back to this server, I delete all the firewall rules. Right, so there's nothing now here. And then we go back to this guy. I'm gonna clear the screen, by the way. I'm going to check the drawing one more time. We have the firewall, the VLAN, the side channeling stuff. Explain that. Yes, okay. Let's see if we rerun the state on that system, if the firewall rules get applied back again. So it's running now, you see? So it seems there's a lot of stuff, a new rule, you see? So it looks, see, it looks pretty nice. So let's go back to the system and press F5. And we see a bunch of firewall rules there. And then we go to the outbound and we see there the outbound rules as well. So now we have like a sort of concept working. What we did now was do it on one system, right? We, for instance, we only targeted this guy, and now we know that works. Now we can target a whole bunch of servers and apply the firewall rule there. And how do we do that? Just specify more minions in your command. So I'm gonna specify all my, that's a couple of guys there. So let's wait. And then we're gonna pick one out if they're all done. See a couple of them already done. They are completed, so let me see, I think the 6 will be a nice guy. Okay, let's RDP to the 6, we'll take the 6 there. Oh, I never logged on to this one, so it's good, I guess. Let's see, get here. There we go. Let's open the firewall here. Let's see. Do it for once clicking here. Okay, we have a lot of firewall rules here, so I'm pretty sure they are somewhere between there. Just gonna remove all the existing firewall rules for now. That's a whole bunch, and we do the same for the outbound. And we're gonna run the state again only on the 5 on this server. We do that by specifying 5. So we're now applying all those firewall rules back again on that system we just broke by removing all the rules. This one is done. It has been completed. So let's see. See, firewall rules are back. Inbound, outbound, everything is back. And use your imagination, of course. You can implement this, of course, in your own environment with the correct IP addresses and network such, and the ports and the protocols and such, and the directions. But this was just for example purposes. Let me see if I forgot something. Let me see the ugly drawing I made. vulnerability, you can do side channeling from there to other VLANs. I showed you the real concerns here. Okay, that was it. I showed you how to create firewall rules with SaltStack on multiple systems at once. Thanks for watching. Hope to see you in the next video. Bye bye.